All right, here's our engine, which is being assembled at this point. We have a serpentine belt conversion on the front of this thing, which is just a great kit. It is a GM product, and it allows us to run a lot of different things on this with a serpentine belt, which basically means one belt that goes all across versus a series of smaller, old-school type belts that can have a... They're not as efficient, and this is a nice conversion, but it has a brand new alternator on here. Nice water pump is down in here. Idler pulleys. Right here we have the nice compressor. And we also have the nice balancer down here, as well as the power steering pump over here. We're going to be using this header. It's called the Ram's Horn Center Dump Header. It's a cast iron header. It does not blow out gaskets. We've been using these for years. They're very efficient. They work well. They may not be as interesting looking as some of these other type of ram's horn headers, but because it's cast iron, it burns really cool and doesn't throw off the heat, plus it doesn't blow out these gaskets here. Center dump allows us to get by the motor mount. Here are the motor mounts, and this is what we're going to weld onto the frame. There'll be a scab plate here, I do believe, and then this will weld onto that plate. The rubber mounts here, in fact, mounts right there as well. Same thing for the other side, you can see that here very well. Fuel pump is right here. Starter. Up top we have the distributor. We'll determine the carburetor up top as well. So other things that will be going on to it will be down here we have a center force clutch as well as the bell housing on the back. And as I look over my shoulder here, this is called a bell housing adapter. It's a Marks kit or an Australian kit, and it goes up to a stock bell housing of which we are sandblasting and painting, and that will be done over here to the left of the, excuse me, to the right. So those will be combined with the clutch, new flywheel. It'll all go in and make for a nice drive line. Behind that will be the H55F transmission as well as a two-piece transfer case. So I think it looks good here.